I'll show it one more time. Explosion. Lots of explosions, does about 10,000 damage, and you can get a wall sprite, because it doesn't need to blow. That's the main part. So you, if you want, you can try and make your combo a little bit more extended by running up, doing attack into this. There we go. Yeah, 10,200 damage, and just then. So just cancel it after his quad 2 or whatever in the air. And you add combo, and it's even good at wall splatting. So yeah, damage up with this. I don't know why it's not working now. It's just because I'm recording, isn't it? There we go. That wasn't optimal, but I still got 13,000, and he was going to be wall splat if he went flying any further. Okay, so for Bakugo's combos, he has a lot of combo freedom. You can do anything into a different explosion and you'll get some sort of decent damage, but I'll show you what you can do to get usually the most damage with Bakugo. And he has different level of difficulties of combos. So what I use as a BNB is probably one of his more difficult combos, but it does a lot of damage. So if I do two attacks, one explosion into the grab, and I hold down quirk one, throw that, oops, and then I dash cancel. And then do the air combo, which is attack into quirk 1s, into quirk 2. So it'll look something like this. Oopsie. And that does almost 10,000 damage, and it doesn't meteor blow, so that you're really likely to get a wall splat if you're facing a combo, just like I just did. You can like do fancier combos, like if you do into the armor attack, and into this, and then into some of these, but then you're really likely to get a meteor blow during a combo, and Bakugo doesn't want that, because then, like, because you usually end your combos with quirk 2. It limits your ability to, if you have a meteor blow, you never want to be using a meteor blow with Bakugo unless you're completely done with your combo, because he can get super easy wall splats. So you're just wasting damage if you get a meteor blow before you get a wall splat. So yeah, basic combo, I'll show it again. Two hits, one explosion into the tilt. Oh, oops. Now I need to throw that out. So two hits, quirk one into tilt quirk two, and then while you're in the tilt quirk two, you hold quirk one. And then quirk 1, dash cancel, 1, quirk 1 into quirk 2. Oops, I did the quirk 2 a bit late there, so it completely missed. Oh yeah, and if you do the quirk 1s a bit too early, they will completely whiff, so be careful about that. Yeah, so this combo is a bit hard to do in some ways. There we go, that did it closer to 10,000 damage, and if I was slightly closer to the wall then I would have definitely gotten the wall splat. As you saw then, Nomo is on recovery, and after this grab into the charged quirk 1, the enemy is in a full state and they can't recover from it. So you can actually, if you want to be really fancy with your combos and do more damage but cheaper, you can technically, after you get this into this, you can run forward into an attack for free, but I find it far too difficult to hit consistently. I'll try to do it in the video, but... well, close. There we go. You saw it there. I did it. If I finished it, it would have done about 10,000 damage, or a bit over 10,000 damage. I accidentally did the dash cancel there. But yeah, if you want, you can try and make your combo a little bit more extended by running up, doing attack into this. There we go. Yeah, 10,200 damage, and you can still get a wall splat. So You can make your combos really fancy and really hard. That's probably the hardest way you can do your combos, is by after you do the tilt quirk 2 into quirk, charged quirk 1, instead of dash cancelling, you just run up and try and time your attack perfectly. But I almost never try to attempt that online, and I've labbed it quite a bit. It's just too hard to get consistently. Yeah, but you can if you want. It does a lot of damage, so by no means am I convincing you to not do it. Try it. Try it. It's fun. If the combo, this combo, is proving a bit too hard for you to do, like online, not that one, but like this one, which is a bit easier. Oops, which I like to mess up, even when I'm recording. I'm gonna dash cancel. But yeah, if this one here is proving a bit hard to do online, he does have simpler combos that you can do. And that involves, you can just do dash cancel from the tilt attack, so you can go 1, 2, explosion, into the quirk, tilt quirk 2, and that dash cancel after that. And that still gets pretty decent damage, 9,800. Actually, is that more than it did with the... No, that does it. Wait. Oh, he messed it up. Oh, in the way. Oh yeah, so it does do a bit less damage. So if you do the version with the charged quirk 1, that does more damage, but it still does really good damage if you just go attack, attack, quirk 1 into tilt quirk 2, and then dash cancel from that, and then go into the air combo. And that still does pretty good damage, and it's quite a bit easier. It's easier to do. And if you want it even more easy, you can go 2 hits into a bunch of quirk 1s. I suggest until it goes to about 8 hits, and then cancel into quirk 2, and then dash cancel from that. So... Oops. And that does decent damage as well. Obviously it's a bit less since it's a bit easier. But you know, sometimes I resort to doing this combo online, like if it's laggy or something, it's a lot easier to do. And you can get a lot easier assured damage. You just want to make sure, because you're messing up timing to go attack into this. Because a lot of time, even I, if it's like laggy or something, I don't manage to actually connect the two hits into the quirk 2. And it does something like this, and then it resets. So yeah, sometimes I like to just stick to simple combos like this. Yeah. You can make it super easy, I guess, if you do 3 hits into the quirk 2, and then dash cancel and do this, but I don't really see why you would do that. That's just getting... This combo here is quite easy. I would recommend sticking with that and getting the, like, 8,900 or whatever it is. Because that's still pretty decent damage. But yeah, the B&B, I'll show it one more time. Explosion. Lots of explosions, does about 10,000 damage, and you can get a wall sprite, because it doesn't meet you. That's the main part. So you can get lots of damage, 10,000, a bit over 10,000 if I did it a bit better there, and then allowed more levels to hit. So yeah, that's basically Bakugo's combos. If you start in the air, you essentially just do the same thing multiple times. So you just this into quirk ones. Oops, that was too many. Yeah, I definitely recommend trying out Bakugo in training mode before you go online, because it takes a lot of practice knowing like how many quirk 1s you should do before you go into quirk 2, and all that kind of technical stuff is really good to know before you go online. And obviously you can try and make it fancy by going into like with this. But that leads to a lot faster of a meteor blow, so I don't recommend doing that too often. If you are in like high in the air and you know you're against the mirror that likes to keep pressing, or what's his name, Gran Torino, that's in the air, and you need to do an armor attack in the air to counter him. If you get a counter attack, I recommend canceling it into his grab, and then just into a regular attack. So tilt attack, tilt quirk 2, regular. into attack, and then into this air sequence. And that'll get you pretty decent damage, and you can dash cancel as well to make it even longer. Okay, now with Bakugo's Plus Ultra 1, he can combo off of basically any of the combos because he can do it in the air. So that makes it really easy for him to- oh look, I messed that combo up just then. So just cancel it after his Quag 2 or whatever in the air. And you add combo, and it's even good at wall splatting. So yeah, you can get lots of damage, super easy. Just add it to the end of your combo if you realize you have a enough for a plus ultra. And then just get super easy damage. And just, yeah, add a big chunk to your combos. And obviously you can do it off the ground as well. What the heck? Now, just a side note, if you have a support like Aizawa or Jiro, it's really easy to combo off of his Plus Ultra 1 just by like using them and calling them out. But since I like to use teams that I like Bakugo with Kirishima and Kaminari, so I tried to find something that works with them, and I found if you do the Plus Ultra when the opponent's in the air, the opponent can recover. So I have Nomura on recover, and you see before he hits the ground, he can recover. But if I do a combo that keeps him on the ground before I hit him with the Plus Ultra, you'll notice he can't recover before he hits the ground. And that, I found, makes it super easy. I can just bring out Kaminari, and he easily connects from any point in the map, because they bounce off the wall, they get sent flying so far. So I go two attacks, it's a bunch of the Quirk 1s, plus Ultra 1, call out Kaminari, run forward. Oh, that was unlucky. I'll try again. What the heck? This was working perfectly before, I'm sorry. Maybe I'm calling Kaminari too early. Whoa. No, why isn't this working? It was working before. Try and call him earlier. What the heck? Why isn't this working? That's so rude. He's working super consistently just before. There. And that accidentally reset, but you can get about like 16,000 damage off of this. I don't know why it's not working now. It's just because I'm recording, isn't it? There we go. That wasn't optimal, but I still got 13,000, and he was gonna be wall splat if he went flying any further. So basically, strategies with his Plus Ultra 1, if you know you're facing a wall like I am now, you're better off just cancelling straight into it and leaving it, not waste your support, because it'll wall splat super easy. And you can get easy damage that way. But if you're facing any direction other than wall, like even in a corner, it works pretty consistently, except for when I'm recording. Like, it was almost constant for me when I was in practice mode. But you just keep them on the ground, and then call out Kaminari, and they'll bounce into his support. What? That is so rude! I don't understand! And I messed it up a bit there, but it would do about like 17,000 or 14,000 damage. So yeah, that's a really consistent way. If you're not facing a wall and you don't have an Aizawa support, because I don't like using Aizawa for no reason, you can use Kaminari. Oops, I called him out a bit, but definitely late there. But yeah, that's basically what I'm trying to get at, is Kaminari can be a really good combo extender for Bakugo. If you don't suck like me, this is so sad. I did it that one time though, and it's usually consistent. I think maybe I'm just bringing him out late. yeah, whatever. It works most of the time unless you're recording. And that's basically combos with Bakugo. Like, if you get his red attack, you just go into the same combos. Just make sure you're going into this situation a lot, and not doing too overextended or fancy combos, or else you'll miss out on your wall splat. And then if you miss out on your wall splat, you're missing out on a lot of damage. See, that was a super easy combo, no dash cancel, and it did like 8,500 damage. And it wasn't even like a proper combo, it was just a random thing in the air. So, yeah, and he has multiple, like I was saying, multiple degrees of difficulties with his combo, so you can either do this one, or you can put in his grab. For even more damage, or you can make it even more damaging by adding the charged quirk 1 in after the grab. And get about 10,000 damage. And if I was facing a bit better angle, you'd get an easy wall splat from that. So that, I think, concludes our Bakugo video. He has really, really interesting combos. He's really fun, really hella crazy. He plays like an absolute psychopath in the right hands, and I think that's how he's supposed to be played. You make sure you are doing tons of explosions, scaring your opponent. He has a really fast run speed, so you can run around and then run in and attack them. And then just make sure you scare them with your like big combos and explosions, so that they have no idea what to do to fight you. Okay, I wouldn't recommend doing that combo in the puzzle to do. That did like nothing. But yeah, make sure, see, look at his really fast run speed. He can run around really well, dash in, bop you on the head with his attack, go into this, you're gonna be wall splat almost every time, so they're gonna be super scared of getting hit. You run around, do his tilt quirk one, just make sure they are always scared of you. They can never just, like, be running around willy-nilly doing cheap stuff, because you have to make sure you are doing all of your explosions. If they're charging in, just keep doing quirk ones, see how they react to that. Charge in, do some mix-ups, charge his red attack like that. That's something that you can do a lot, because a lot of the time I'm going to be going into this, if that's safe and breaks block like I was showing before. So you can cancel into the red attack. And you can always add a big chunk of damage by adding his plus ultra 1. Anyways, guys, that's Bakugo in a nutshell. I hope you really enjoyed, and everyone that was requesting him, I hope this is what you expected, and I'm glad you requested him. He's really fun. Anyways, guys, thanks, and I'll see you in the next one.